Blessed Gregory, raised upon the throne of Peter, sought always the beauty of the Lord and lived in celebration of that love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Gregory the Great. In this Mass, we also remember our dear former Archbishop Rufino Cardinal Santos as we remember his passing into eternal life today. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us ask the Lord for pardon and for strength. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them in love, through the intercession of Pope Saint Gregory, endow, we pray, with the spirit of wisdom, those to whom you have given authority to govern, that the flourishing of a holy flock may become the eternal joy of the shepherds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit scrutinizes everything, even the depths of God. Among men, who knows what pertains to the man except his spirit that is within? Similarly, no one knows what pertains to God except the Spirit of God. We have not received the Spirit of the world, but the Spirit who is from God, so that we may understand the things freely given us by God. And we speak about them not with words taught by human wisdom, but with words taught by the Spirit, describing spiritual realities in spiritual terms. Now, the natural man does not accept what pertains to the Spirit of God, for to him it is foolishness, and he cannot understand it, because it is judged spiritually. The one who is spiritual, however, can judge everything, but is not subject to judgment by anyone. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to counsel him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
The Lord is just in all his ways,
making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is faithful in all his words and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling and raises up all who are bowed down.
The Lord is just in all his ways. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus went down to Capernaum, a town of Galilee. He taught them on the Sabbath, and they were astonished at his teaching, because he spoke with authority. In the synagogue, there was a man with a spirit of unclean demon, and he cried out in a loud voice, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Be quiet, come out of the man." Then the demon threw the man down in front of them and came out of him without doing him any harm. They were all amazed and said to one another, "What is there about these words? For with authority and power he commands the unclean spirits, and they come out." And the news of him spread everywhere in the surrounding region. Beloved, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po, and I hope you are all safe and sound as we celebrate this Eucharist. And we offer our prayers still for our brothers and sisters who are suffering terribly because of the Bagyong Enteng. And we are here to support you spiritually and in the many other ways that we can, as we also raise your prayers and your concerns to God. You may have heard the saying, words can either make you or break you. Napakalakas po kasi ng mga salita. Napakamakapangyarihan ng mga salita natin. Kaya po pwedeng makasira o makagawa o makabuo ng damdamin o ng diwa ng isang tao ang mga sinasabi po natin. The people of Capernaum, those who witnessed the freedom or the healing of this man with unclean spirit, were all amazed how Jesus freed this man. They even said, "What is there about his word? For with authority and power, he commands the unclean spirits and they come out." They were amazed how words can be that powerful. Amazed how words can change a person and make a person free again. Hindi lang naman po sa kwentong ito nagsalita si Jesus. Pero sa lahat ng pagkakataon, nagsalita siya ng mga malalakas, matitindi, straight to the point ng buong puwersang mga salita para mabago ang puso at buhay ng tao. Although, as a response, people may be disturbed. They may even ask questions. They may have second thoughts. But Jesus would always give words not only to speak, not only to be powerful, but to change us and form us. This is one thing that we need to appreciate and make ourselves attentive when we use words. Alam naman po natin at sinabi nga natin kaninang malakas ang salita. Gawin po natin ang lahat para makatulong tayo sa iba, sa pagpabago ng iba. Do not be shy to express your hearts when things are wrong. God has given us words to help others grow, to help others for their healing, to help others for their good and for the best of their lives. Alam nating malakas ang pananalita, pero wag naman nating gamitin ito sa ikapapahamak at ikasisira ng iba. Minsan, masakit tayong magsalita, pero ang sanang lamanan ng puso ay para mabago ang iba. Our words may sometimes be painful and strong, but it may bring others hope and drive to live others and to live life again. Words can either make you or break you. They can indeed break us and make us. Kailangan tayong saktan, kailangan tayong gisingin, kailangan tayong kurutin pag nagsalita ang iba at kapag nagsalita ang Diyos. It is there to help us be better as well and to make our life beautiful and hopeful as well.
Please stand.
Through the gospel, Christ speaks to us with words of eternal authority and deeds of healing power. Through him, let us pray with confidence. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to teach Christ's truth and combat the evils of our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may promote righteousness in their governments and be zealous in eradicating evils in the societies they are sworn to serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may not grow idle in our prayer life, so that the unclean spirits may not take over our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who suffer may be freed from their bodily or spiritual afflictions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may enjoy the radiant dawn of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all of the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for each other and for our brothers and sisters suffering because of the typhoon. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we rejoice in your abundant love for us. Establish your authority within us, and be our companion on the road of life. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice we present in celebration of Saint Gregory may be for our good, since through its offering you have loosened the offenses of all the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us on the festival of Saint Gregory, you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Rufino, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection.
Remember also our brothers and sisters, for today we dedicate also for the soul of Jome Garcia Binstead, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and to all the saints, to Gregory, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Hmm. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Through Christ the Teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Saint Gregory they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We would like to thank all of you for your presence and your support, and also for being with us this morning as we celebrate our Holy Mass, although I know the storm and the rain is quite heavy this morning. Thank you for the effort and for your presence, and for our solidarity as well for our brothers and sisters suffering because of this typhoon. We extend to them always our love and our support. We also would like to thank Father Louis from the Alagad ni Maria for being with us as well this morning. Maraming salamat po, Father. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.